In this video, you'll see how to set AWS Elastic Disaster Recovery launch templates at scale. With this solution, you can set launch templates automatically rather than manually, perform AWS Elastic Disaster Recovery Service, or DRS, API calls through code, and observe a best practice of asset management. We'll begin in the AWS Elastic Disaster Recovery console, where we currently have 6 source servers, each with a corresponding launch template. Let's drill down into one of the servers and review its launch settings. Launch templates cannot be edited in a batch using the native DRS tooling, so by default, each launch template needs to be set manually. Let's return to our server list. To automate the process of setting launch templates for source machines, we can use Lambda functions to edit all launch templates that have been tagged with a matching key in the Amazon Elastic Disaster Recovery console. Let's take a look at one of these servers' tags. This is a database server and it's tagged as DB. So, using the Lambda functions, we can create one launch template for all servers tagged as DB. The Lambda functions are fully deployed as code in the AWS sample repository on GitHub. This package contains full instructions for cloning the repository and setting up all of its components. Let's view the solution architecture. The solution consists of the AWS Elastic Disaster Recovery console, an Amazon Simple Storage Service, or Amazon S3 bucket for template storage, and 2 Lambda functions. We'll look at these functions again later on. Let's return to the Amazon Elastic Disaster Recovery console. Let's view the tag for another source server. This server is tagged as app. For the purposes of this example, we have already created launch templates for the app tag and the DB tags. Let's view the app launch template. These are all the fields that can be included in a launch template. Most of these fields are currently set to null, but we can modify them as needed. Notice that the instance type is set to t3.small. Next, let's view the DB launch template. The instance type in this template is set to t3.large. Let's upload both templates to the Amazon S3 bucket we've already set up for our solution. Now that we've uploaded the templates, let's return to the architecture overview in GitHub and review how our solution responds to the upload. When we add JSON launch templates to the bucket, the first Lambda function, setDRSTemplates, automatically updates the DRS servers that are tagged with the prefix of the uploaded JSON template files. Let's go back to the Amazon Elastic Disaster Recovery console to confirm that this occurred when we uploaded our templates. This is our server tagged as app. Let's review its launch settings. Notice that the instance type is set to t3.small in accordance with the app template we uploaded. Let's check the DB server. This server has inherited the t3.large instance type from the DB launch template. Let's go back to the server list and try adding a new server to one of these tag groups. We'll remove this server's existing tags and then tag it as an app server. Now that we've added the tag, let's take a look at the Lambda function that will set the server's launch template. This Lambda function, schedule_drs_templates, periodically looks for any new DRS servers that are tagged and then pulls the corresponding launch template. For our purposes, we'll trigger the function manually by running a test. Next, let's verify that the server we tagged as app inherited our app launch template. As expected, the server's instance type is now t3.small, in accordance with our app template. If we had large numbers of servers with a matching tag, we could automatically set launch templates for all of them at once using this solution. You've just seen how to set AWS Elastic Disaster Recovery launch templates at scale. You can learn more about this topic in the description and links for this video. Thanks for watching. Now it's your turn to try.